Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.
Well, congratulations are in order to Regina Wedig, who is the district governor for Rotary in our area, well known as both an Amite attorney and a longtime Rotary member. In fact, you use the play on words that we dig Rotary with your last name. But we digress, 29 clubs in your district?
49 clubs. There are 49 clubs in Louisiana and Mississippi. So we cover most of Louisiana on this side of the Mississippi River, from New Orleans, Plaquemines, St. Bernard, St. John, St. Charles, all the way up through Tangipahoa Parish. And then on Mississippi, Summit and straight over Hattiesburg and then down to the coast. It's an interesting journey from becoming a member of a club about 12 years ago, I guess, to now standing before you as your district governor. It's fun, kinda, you know? It's a little bit of work involved with it. But the opportunity to really get to know Rotarians, and there are over 1,700 Rotarians in our district, is really exciting. It's inspiring, and it's something that I encourage all of you to try to get to do, and that is meet more Rotarians. You'll become much more of a Rotarian because you understand the passions of somebody else. And that's what all this is about. We're a service organization. And without your ideas, without your passion, we can't move forward. So let's try to do that. Each year, the president of Rotary International announces a theme. And that theme is usually a reflection of the character, the ideas, the dreams of that particular person. This year, Jennifer Jones is the president of Rotary International, and her theme is Imagine. I like it. I like her theme. Because Imagine Rotary is what we as Rotarians have been doing for 117 years. Every project, as you know, starts with the imagination of a Rotarian. Your club is a good example. To celebrate your 100th anniversary, you as a club got together and came up with the idea of, we need a clock. We need something to be able to point to in our community that says, we're here and we're here to stay, come join us. So hopefully having that clock will generate some questions. Who are these people? What does this mean? Why is there this clock that, is it green like most of them are? Okay, so, you know, it's got the Rotary seal on it. And does it have when your meetings are? Did they let you do that or not? Do they let you put a little plaque on there that says what time you meet? Good. So before I talk about the kind of the things that I'm hoping we will do as a district, I do want to give you some important dates of things that are coming up. The first one on my list happened last night, so I can skip that one. But I'm going to tell you about it anyway, because it's important for future years. And that is RILA. RILA is going on all this week. I was out there Monday talking with the kids. Sparky, I know, went last night. I don't know if any of the others of you went. There's always a family night for RILA. And if you don't know what RILA is, it is Rotary Youth Leadership Awards. It is a program that our district is one of the few that makes it an all-week event. A lot of places only may do it 1 or 2 days. So we give these kids between their junior and senior year a chance to come learn about being leaders and what it means to work with people you've never met before, because these are kids throughout the district. Some of their parents are Rotarians, some are not. A lot of them don't have a clue what Rotary is. And so they come together and they're put in these groups, and just like you do when you come to a new club, you have to learn about what makes everybody do what they do, where their talents are, and everything else. So we're starting young, you know? We've got Interact clubs, and now we've got RILA, and we have Rotaract clubs, and we have all these opportunities. be thinking as you look forward to this year, if you know of students who should attend RILA next year. Usually the nominations have to be in by mid-May, and that can be a sliding date kind of a little bit. But think about it. If you've got friends who have kids that are in that age group, suggest that they do that. The next one is Vibrant Club Assembly. Has anybody here other than Sparky been to a Vibrant Club Assembly for Rotary in our district? You won't know that what we're doing this year is brand new then, because we've decided that what we want to do is we want to focus more on you. We want to focus on the relationships that you have with each other in your club, your territory, and the district. One of the things I like about your newsletter or your minutes is it now lists the things that are coming up both here and in the district. That's great. I'm going to put him, Mike, in touch with Chuck Mutes. No, because Chuck is the public image deputy governor for my team, which means he wants to get as much information as he can so that everybody knows what your clubs are doing. Because imagine if when you have a fundraiser, you no longer have just the people in this room or the businesses they represent to ask, can you buy a ticket? Can you come play golf? How about going down to the Alligator Festival or buying a duck for a quackophilia? You know, if you knew about these things, you might just go. So, you know, we're trying to get that information. So Vibrant Clubs is going to be on Saturday, August the 20th at the Ponchatoula Rotary Hut. Most of you know where that is, I hope. Okay. Sparky's team is going to feed us jambalaya, so that in and of itself is a reason to come. There's no registration fee. It'll last from about 8 in the morning to about 1, and that includes lunch. We're going to talk about membership, but we're also going to do our version of speed dating, okay? Everyone there will have 2 minutes to talk to everybody else in a rotating line, obviously, to talk about what their club does. If you've been to mid-year checkup, which is the next thing on my list, if you've been to mid-year checkup, you know that clubs get 2 minutes at that event to talk about, to brag about their clubs. Well, you get this opportunity, 2 minutes is not nearly enough time for you to write down all the great ideas that you hear. When you hear that one of the clubs on the Gulf Coast did a paddle the bay and they raised $30,000. When you hear that the Metairie Club consistently raises over $100,000 with their big game raffle, you really kind of have some thoughts in the back of your mind. I wonder how that got started. What did they do? You know, how many people does it take? How do we do that? Do we participate with them or what? You guys do the Shamrock Run, right? So you know that takes a lot of work, year in and year out. Imagine if you were able to really promote that Shamrock Run throughout the district. There's lots of people that are runners that are trying to get all of their time in and everything else. So that's what we're going to do at Vibrant Club. We're going to talk about some other things too. But come. I urge you to come. It's a great, informal, casual way of getting to know other Rotarians in the district. One of the other things that will happen at Vibrant Clubs is immediate past president Bob Vaughn has a long list of awards to give out. And your club just may be on that list of recipients or some people in this room, so you might ought to come. You might just decide, let me see what these awards are all about, because this is the way we recognize and thank you for the things that you do. Mid-year checkup, Saturday, January 14th in Bay St. Louis. Has anybody ever attended? other than Sparky, because he's there. Mike, yes. So as I mentioned earlier, it's a great opportunity to let your club talk about what your goals are and how close you are to achieving them mid-year. It's really, really fun. And then those awards that weren't given out at Vibrant Club will probably be given out there. And then, and thank you for putting it on your minutes, our district conference next year is April 20th through 23rd, and it's in Hattiesburg. So you don't have to drive all the way to the coast. You don't have to fight the traffic going into New Orleans, all these other places where it has traditionally been over the last 10 years or so. We're going up to Hattiesburg. We already know that we're going to have a golf tournament. Everything is going to be on USM's campus, including Food Fest. We have a great facility for doing that. This place, if you've been to Food Fest, you know sometimes it gets a little warm. Well, we're doing this in April as opposed to May, so it should be a little bit better. But also, this is a covered pavilion that has electricity, running water, fans, all sorts of stuff. So it's going to be kind of fun to do it there. We've got some surprises, so they're still in the planning stage. We do have a couple of weeks before we really have to resolve everything. Check the website, please. You can go on there and keep up. I'll give you a little hint. Every promotion that we have for the district conference, please search for a giraffe. And then let me know what you think. All of these are connected by what theme? Imagine. Because at all of these meetings, what we do is we imagine a way to get to know one another better, to be inspired, to come back with some new ideas, and to know that you've shared your ideas with another club. There are lots of clubs that are going to be celebrating their 100th anniversary in the next 5 years. Perhaps they would like to know what the process is to do something like getting a clock or having a big party or doing all the various things to celebrate what a great event, 100 years of Rotary or more in your community. As Bob Vaughn always says, or actually as Andrew Ward, who's another Rotarian that is almost as big of a personality as Vicky Gutierrez, he says, but wait, there's more. Right? So Bob was at the meeting yesterday, so I had him, I'd point to him and he would say that. All right, we're having a scavenger hunt all year round about clubs. Starts in August with the second newsletter, because we already have the July newsletter out. It's a scavenger hunt. Every month between now and April, there'll be clues in that newsletter about clubs. Some about people, but mostly about clubs. The person who has the most correct answers, we have a fabulous prize. I'm not going to tell you what it is until later in the year. Because by then, you know, some people already have a head start. But believe me, it would be well worth your time to read the newsletter once a month. You have a limited amount of time to try to figure out what club I'm talking about. You may have to use your skills in looking at things on the district website or the Facebook page or website of a club, but that's okay. The purpose is for us to get to know one another and to have some fun. Another passion of mine is children's education. So I'm asking, whenever you have an event, whether it is an evening social, a meeting, a fundraiser, service project, please consider donating children's books. In fact, I don't care. They can be, you know, books for teenagers or adults or anything else, but I'd like to focus on books for children 5 and under or 7 and under. Because I've talked to Melissa Stilley and she's excited about me doing this project. And she said that that's the age where kids really need to learn how to handle a book and see the pictures and look at the words and have someone read to them. It's so important. Imagine if we had several thousand books at my conference in April of next year that we can then sort out and distribute, especially to rural clubs, so that those kids get to come and pick up books at no charge to them. Think about the impact. Does your club do a dictionary project program? Okay. All right. As you may know, the dictionary project is one that is sponsored by Rotary International. It's not a Rotary International requirement or anything else like that. There are several different publishers who produce these dictionaries. Most clubs that do this project give out books to third graders, dictionaries to third graders. In our club, we've been doing it for a long time. Lee Gray, who was one of our members, came up with the idea to bring it to this particular area. I can tell you, when we talk to kids that are in high school at Interact, or if they're applying for a Rotary scholarship, or they just happen to come chat with us, the vast majority of them remember that a Rotarian came to them when they were in third grade and gave them a dictionary and had some fun with them exploring words. So you never know what impact your small act may have on the people around you. So keep doing them. You know, I'm super proud of all the Rotarians in the district, including all of you, because I get to know you. I now have 1,700 more friends, yeah. Some of whom, no, I won't say that. Well, yeah, I will. Some of them block my email. Carly would never do that. Yes. But anyway. So what are my goals? If you don't know, Carly started working for me right out of law school. So
Regina's talking to me a little.
So if she makes mistakes, don't blame them on me. But no. So what do I want to focus on? Besides kind of the things, you see a theme running through what I'm trying to do by how I'm developing these programs and these meetings and things like that. I want to stress that we get back to becoming friends with members of our club. Don't just see them at lunchtime. Do other things. I like the idea of once a week you might have a bunch get together, and that's a rotating event because you never know who's going to show up. So come, do that. Invite other people to come. I can assure you that as you become more friends with more people, you get more and more opportunities for somebody to say, what are you talking about? What's this group you keep mentioning? What can I do? It really sounds like a good group of people. What can I do? Invite them. Out of curiosity, how many people in here have ever sponsored a new member for your club? Good. The rest of you got a challenge. You know, a couple years ago, one of the programs that Rotary International put out was Everyone Bring One. And it was a plea to at least once a year bring someone who knows nothing about Rotary to an event. Let them meet with the other people here. Let them find out what Rotary is all about. And remember that as your membership grows, the projects that you do get better, they get bigger. You have more people to carry the load. The same people don't have to recycle as officers quite as often. So, you know, there's all sorts of benefits besides having more fun and getting to know more people. Imagine new ways to engage with your community. You have speakers almost every week. Instead of just saying thank you for coming and everything else, listen to what they're saying, because if they're here, they think it's important enough for you to hear what they're doing. So think about what they represent in your community and how you can respond back to them to help them do whatever it is they're doing better. And also, ask them to become a member of your club. It's amazing how often we forget to do that. You know, we have these people, they've never been to a Rotary club before, they come, They hear all about all the events that we're having, all the things we're doing, all the service projects, you know, and they walk out and they never hear from us again. So be conscious of that, because I want us to imagine new ways to engage with the community. Find out what's really going on. We're all in business, so we all have a sense of what's going on in our narrow profession, sometimes a little bit beyond that. But think about all the different professions that are represented in this group. Do you know what everybody in this club does for a living? Do you know what they do? Do you know what their passions are? Do you know what they do, you know, what social events they like to attend? Those are the questions that I want to plant in your mind to think about, because it's fun. Imagine new ways to communicate with other clubs. And I touched on this a little bit before. I heard some of you talking about some of the things that you do, and I mentioned before, let's get together and work as clubs together. Instead of a meet having a catfish dinner and a golf tournament, think about a meet Kentwood, Hammond, Hammond Ponchatoula Sunrise, Ponchatoula, having a bigger event where you're not asking the same person over and over and over again to come to your event, because you now have this all throughout the district. And if they don't like to play golf, I'm a miniature golf person and not very good at it. But if you come to me and ask me, sign up for the golf tournament, I'm going to tell you, I'm sorry, I'm not really interested. And so think about the different things you can do with other clubs. This is what Metairie Club does. They go out and do all the work. They usually get between 40 and 60 prize groups. And that could be the Saints football games. They almost always have the LSU-Alabama tickets. They have restaurants. They have jewelry, gift certificates, all this kind of stuff. They bundle into these little packages, and they print up these tickets. They're usually $20 a piece. But what they do for your club, for example, every ticket you sell, you get to keep $10. You can make money for your club. That's just one example. There are others throughout the district. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to ask clubs, send me the information about your projects. I need to know what it is, the date, contact person. I'm going to hopefully develop this directory on the district website, separate and above from the calendar that lists all the events, so that there's sort of a glossary. If you want to see how another club does a 5K run, you can glance through there, find out their contact person, and give them a call. Say, okay, how do we improve ours? Or can we help you improve yours? So let's work together. Imagine what we can do as a district. When we know what's going on in other clubs, we get outside of our own comfort zone. We get outside of just coming for lunch or breakfast or an occasional drink together and things like that. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's a great start. But let's be Rotarians. Let's do more than that. Let's talk about what we do with Rotary to our friends, our family members, our coworkers. Let them see what a great time. And you should talk to them more often than going up to them and saying, can you buy a ticket? Right? But you could tell them that, because then you get a chance to tell them what you're using the money for. Never pass up the opportunity to let other people know the good things your club is doing in the community. You're not just raising money. You're raising money to do something. You're raising money to help someone else. And that's inspiring to people. There are lots of people who are in all these other organizations. Find out about them. Work with them. Invite them to your events. See what we can do. Imagine when we are so excited about Rotary that other people want to come and share that excitement with you. Volunteer your time to be an officer of your club. Volunteer your time to be on a committee for the district. Sparky is, as an assistant governor, is working with us on getting together what's known as the Territory Resource Network. This was a dream of Bob Vaughn, who said in all of our meetings, let's think about having people take that first little step of going outside of their club and being a resource for the other clubs in the territory on something you're really passionate about. Membership, foundation giving, service projects, public image. There's all these opportunities for you to step up and talk about that. And then when a club needs a speaker, you have all these people ready and waiting to be invited to come talk about their love of whatever scope it is. So think about that. Then take that other step up. Volunteer for other committees at the district level. We're really not scary people. We don't expect you to ignore your family and your job, your club, and spend all your time doing these things. The more people we have that are interested and can help out, the better we become. Everybody doesn't have to do, one person doesn't have to do everything. You know, we've got some people on the board of our district that wear three or four hats. You know, they're the deputy governor for finance and the deputy governor for grants and the deputy governor for foundation. You know, if any of these areas, or go to the website and look to see if any of these areas you've got some sort of an interest in, I'm not asking you to become a deputy governor. Call them up and say, I'd like to learn a little bit more. What else can we do? What else can we do? There's a long list of things that district governors always come and talk about. Foundation giving, what the membership numbers are, Paul Harris, Polio Plus, and all those things. My philosophy is, all of that's numbers. If you're not engaged as a Rotarian, I could sit up here and tell you how much your club has contributed to Rotary Foundation, and how many of your members are Paul Harris Fellows, and on and on and on. But it doesn't matter to you. Until you love Rotary and love being part of this organization, those are numbers. As you become more comfortable being a Rotarian, you'll seek out. You'll go to different sites and find out more information. I'm trying to create a culture in our district that focuses on you, your members, because without members, without ideas, we're a lunch club. We're, you know, 49 lunch clubs, and we're not that in this district. So let's help one another. Thank you for letting me come today. Thank you for the volunteer time, passions, and enthusiasm that you have for all of yours. By the way, I'll give you my email address. Carly, do not laugh, okay? My email address for this year, other than my work, is, anybody guess? WeDigRotary@gmail.com.
I'm Tenspo Parish Clerk of Court, Gary Stanga, and here's what our poll commissioners have to say.
I enjoyed being a poll commissioner because I was gone from this area for 17 years, and it came back and it helped me reconnect with my community, and I wanted to be part of the election process.
I'm Alicia Fasell, Chief Deputy with the Tangipahoa Parish Clerk of Court's office. Poll commissioners play an important part of the election process, and it's only a one-day commitment. We invite you to visit tangiclerk.org for more information.